Hey guys, how's it going? My name is Crystal and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm gonna be doing a no brand makeup look for people with glasses. I just got these new, and I can't even say it with a straight face, Gucci glasses. Who do I think that I am that I have the audacity to buy Gucci glasses? But they were half price on Black Friday. I just really liked the frames. I'm very picky, and these were my favorites out of the ones that I tried on. So I got them, half off, great deal. Anyways, they have a lot more real estate with the actual lens because the frame's a little bit bigger than my normal ones. And it gives me a little bit more space to showcase my makeup that I wear if I'm gonna wear makeup with my glasses. So usually I wear my glasses during the weekdays when I go to work. I just find that when I wake up really early and I have insomnia, so I don't sleep very well, my eyes burn if I try to put my contacts in the morning. So half of the time, more than half of the time, I'm wearing glasses to work, or, you know, not to work, just on an average day. But I am gearing this makeup look more towards people who go to work and want to look a little bit more put together, but they also wear glasses. Since this is a very basic neutrals look, I thought it would be a good opportunity to do a no brand tutorial, just because I feel like, especially lately, there's been so many launches with so many brands with eyeshadows and colorful makeup, you know? I just think that if you have a neutral palette and you can find a color similar to the ones that I'm using, you can recreate this look so easily. If you haven't yet, please hit subscribe. Yes, I remembered to do it in the beginning of the video today. Woo! I would love to have you, so please hit that little red button down there. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you make it to the end of the video, please leave a comment down below. In case you guys were wondering, it is crazy outside right now. Like, let me take you. Let's do a bit of a vlog. Look. Hi. You look so cute. Are you enjoying your snow day? Yes? Yes. Look at that. It is white out. That's the road. I mean, it's downright beautiful, but not good conditions for driving or anything. But anyways, let's get back to the makeup. I've prepped my face. I used moisturizer and I did prime. So next we're gonna go into, I'm gonna do concealer first. The first thing I wanna do is look in the mirror and see where exactly my glasses are hitting on my nose. Sometimes you'll push them up, you know, but if you move your face around, they're not supposed to move all that much, right? Like if you look down, they're not supposed to slide off your face. I wanna see where exactly they're hitting on my face so that I know that that's an area that makeup is gonna come off of. I find that when I do my under eye concealer, I have a lot of darkness in here. Especially right in here, I have a lot of darkness. My glasses hit about here. I don't want to put too much product there, otherwise when I move around, it's gonna get build up on my glasses, on the nose piece, and it's just gonna look gross if ever I have to take them off, or if you can see it bunching up in front of the nose piece. That's the first thing I'm gonna do. I can already tell where that is. And if you've been wearing your glasses in the morning, you're gonna have a little bit of a mark there. So that's always a good tip. But that's where I'm gonna keep the product really thin. I'm gonna do my best not to put concealer right on the bridge of my nose where that piece is gonna hit. Put my Gucci glasses somewhere safe, you know what I mean? Okay, protect the Gucci's, but forget the elf, am I right? Oh God, not the camera, anything but the camera. That's right, I don't have to tell you what concealer I'm using. So, as you can see, I'm putting it in here and a little bit up, get where that darkness is. But notice how I'm not bringing it too much down towards the bridge. I'm trying to keep it up tight near like my lash line and inner corner. And then with my sponge, I'm gonna try to keep this really up there, you know? I'll drag it down a little bit, but as for that nose area, I'm not gonna try to hit too much right there. Now I'm gonna powder so I can set that. I like to powder with my beauty sponge. I just find that a brush doesn't really cut it for me. It makes it look too cakey and moves product around. I like to take a very minimal amount and make sure that I set that. So already I'm looking more awake I am ready for work, kind of. You know, ready to get my day started. Next, I'm gonna do foundation. You don't have to use foundation. I've said it before, I think, in a video. I never used to wear foundation. I used to do concealer only in the places where I needed it. The reason why I started wearing foundation is because I was covering more space on my face. I started wearing full foundations, but I would only put them where I need them. My skin, I feel like, again, on my nose, I'm gonna try to keep it away from where my glasses hit, so that's, again, right in here. And I'm trying to keep it down away from there so that product doesn't bunch up and do weird things there. All right, and then to set that, this is when I use a pressed powder. And I use one that has a little bit more coverage than just like a translucent. I take it on the back. And this powder, I like to kind of buff across my face, not just in the areas where I put foundation, just because I feel like it makes it a lot more even. And pro tip here for you, try not to put so much product right here, especially if you make a lot of facial expressions like I do, because product will bunch up there. Noticing a pattern? Are you noticing a theme? Now I'm gonna contour and blush and highlight and all that good stuff. A good rule that I like to follow is like trying to hit it right at the top of the ear, and then I've been kind of trying to swoop it like up and back. And then I blend it into my temple because I want to make sure it's blended. And then I'll go in with like a lighter contour color and just go over that. And I'm always trying to blend up, not down. That's what makes it look muddy if you're blending it down. And then I always get my forehead right over my hairline. Why am I speaking? Like I'm ending a sentence and then just leaving it running on. I don't know. I like the look, and it's not for contour so much. I just like the look of like a bronze, not forehead, but like hairline part of your forehead. And then I take the excess on the brush and I pinch it like this. And then I get the sides of my nose. Cause while I don't like a snatched nose because I don't feel like it fits my face, I do like having a little bit more definition on the tip. Next for blush, I'm gonna kind of go for, and you can do whatever you like. I'm gonna go for more of maybe like tan, coral, neutral blush tones today. Although yellow blush is coming in style now. I just saw Jay Kiss's video. I have to try it. Maybe I'll use one of the colors in the Honey ColourPop palette for it. And what I like to do is take my blush over my nose a little bit just to blend it, because I don't like a line where my blush ends. And for highlight, I'm gonna go with like a champagne or a gold type of a color to, again, keep with the neutral theme. And typically what I like to do on my nose is go a little bit up here and then stop, leave a little space there, and then get the tip. And I think today I'm only gonna get the tip because my glasses are gonna be blocking that initial strip on the bridge. So I think I'm just gonna get the tip of my nose and obviously my Cupid's bow. And to keep it cohesive, I'm gonna hit the inner corner with the color that I'm using as well. Now we're gonna move on to the eyes. So again, for the eyes, we're gonna keep it very neutral. If you wanted to keep it really cohesive, like I said, and something really quick, like you're in a rush to work, you don't really wanna spend too much time on your makeup, you can go in and use the bronzer or contour that you were using and put that in the sockets of your eyes, put that champagne highlighter on your lid and in your corner, and you're pretty much set for eyeshadow. You know, you don't have to pull out another product. However, I can't do that. I can, but I don't want to. I'm gonna go a little bit more warm, I think. I'm gonna go warm to neutral today. So I'm gonna take a transition shade for my skin tone. It's leaning a little bit yellow, something that's not too dark to kind of blow out the crease, you know? So that's a little bit more of a really light, warmer nude color. Then I'm gonna take a brush that's a little bit smaller than that. Still a fluffy brush, but a little bit smaller, so it's a little bit more dense. And I'm gonna pick up a color a little bit darker and get it right in the outer V for a little more definition and right in the socket. I'm gonna blend it a little bit, not too much, but just so it softens everything a little bit more. I'm gonna take that shade down on the lower lash line. And if I use this brush, it's gonna really smoke it out, so it's not gonna be too crazy looking. And then I'm gonna go back in with that first blending brush and make sure that I just blend that all out. Nothing is too harsh. Oh my gosh, I might be losing power. Yay! I'm torn. I don't know if I should do a shimmery color on the lid or keep it matte. I'm gonna keep it matte. So typically I would use a brush with a matte eyeshadow. Currently, I didn't bring one with me. So I'm gonna go in with like just a neutral eyeshadow close to the color of my skin. And actually the one that I'm using is very close to that first crease color that I used. It's in the same family. It's significantly lighter, obviously. That could be it for eyeshadow. You can use a dark brown shadow and like a pencil brush and just kind of smudge something there and then put mascara on and you're good to go. You could also use a pencil liner. You could use no liner and then just your mascara and go. For what I personally like to do, I like a wing. I'm a wing girl through and through. However, for this look, I am just gonna be smudging a darker gel or cream pencil on my lash line and then going to mascara. I just want a little bit of definition right at the lash line. You see, it's not too much. Like compared to this eye, it just gives a little bit more definition and I like that look. We're gonna do the same thing on this eye, keeping it really tight. I didn't go the whole way across my lash line. I kept it from like the middle of my eye, so right where your iris. What is the black part? Is that your cornea? Somebody help. I know the anatomy of an eye. The fovea is in the back. Oh my God. What is it called? Okay, I can't remember. All right, the center of your eye. The center of your eye, right in the middle of the black part. So I went that far and then I kept it thicker on the outside and then thinned it out towards the middle there. I don't know if you could tell, but that's what I did. I didn't go all the way in. That also keeps it on the natural side. And then to open up my eyes, I'm going in with a beige liner on the inner rim, my waterline, if you will. You could also go in with a white, or if you're wearing a certain color outfit, you can go in with that color, but like a really light color. You guys have seen me do this a bunch of times with like a light blue or a light purple. I've done light green, light pink I've been done because I'm crazy. That you gotta be careful with that one though, because that could look like you have pink eye or eye irritation. Anyways, I'm gonna try to open up my eyes, stop looking so tired, and I'm gonna use a beige for this. This is one of the first things I learned when I started watching YouTube. Well, not when I started watching YouTube, but when I started watching makeup videos on YouTube. Because when I first started watching YouTube, I used to watch Jenna Marbles and Shane Dawson. And then I started watching people like Tiffany D and Emily Noel. Then I found Glam Life Guru, Juicy Star 07, All That Glitters 21. All those people. Michelle Phan, are you kidding me? Bubs Beauty. Now I'm going to leave the room again and go get my eyelash curler and my mascara because I didn't bring it in here. Oh my Lord. Okay. I definitely would recommend curling your lashes because I don't have super long lashes, but my lashes are long enough with mascara that they touch my lens when I wear glasses because I like my glasses high on the bridge of my nose. I like them closer to my eyes. When I push my glasses and I'm wearing a lot of mascara, a lot of the times they'll hit my lens when I'm blinking and it bothers me. It makes a noise that I can hear. I'm gonna curl them and make sure that they're not sticking out at my lens. Okay, and then I like to go in with a regular mascara, one that's not waterproof, and then I'll do a coat of that and then a coat of waterproof mascara, just generally, because sometimes my eyes get watery and I like things where they are. But taking off waterproof mascara is a pain in the butt. You don't have to, you can use whatever mascara you like. That's just something that I do. And when I do my mascara, I go under, like a typical person, and then I go on top of my lashes. That's something I learned from Juicy Star 07 way back in the day. Well, that's nice. My eye is having an allergic reaction. That's cute, that's fun. That was from me rubbing my eye, by the way. Black part of the eye, what is that? Hey Siri, hey Siri. Can you tell me what the black part of your eye is?
Okay, I found this on the web for, can you tell me what the black part of your eye is? Check it out.
Dang it, I was right, my cornea? What part of your eye expands and contracts with light? Pupil, my pupil, that's what it is. Not my cornea, the cornea is on the layer on top. Pupils dilate, that's the phrase I was telling myself in my mind. Thank you. I know that this video is getting a little long for like work makeup, but there's a lot of optional components in this. Work with me here, okay? I'm gonna go and do my brows. You don't have to. I never used to do my brows, but I like my tail filled a little bit more now. That's what I'm gonna do. I do a little bit right in here, in the front part, just a little bit, and then I blend that out. And then I do right here and right down the tail. That's it, nothing major. Ma'am? And for my brows, they're a little bit unruly and I like that little extra step in there to make everything look more cohesive. And next I'm gonna take any type of lipstick. I'm gonna stick with the nude brown, a little bit orangey side of things. You don't have to, you use whatever lipstick you want. Sometimes I'll go a little bit more, ooh, I love a mauve. I love a mauve. Mauve Unite by Revlon is one of my all-time favorite lipsticks. It is so phenomenal. Lately I've been into the brown caramel nudes, colors like Brink from ColourPop. That's not what I'm using. I'm using a liquid lipstick. You can use a bullet lipstick. You can use a chapstick. You don't have to put anything on your lips. You can go out the door with a chapstick on or a clear lip gloss. You can only wear a lip gloss. There are so many options for you. This is just what I'm doing. Something else I really like to do if I'm going to work and I have a lipstick I really want to wear, but it's either not work appropriate or wearing it full on is I feel like too much for work, I will put a chapstick and then dab like a few dots of that color on there and then I'll blend it in with my finger so I get the color but not so opaque. Ta-da! There we have it! What do we think? It looks very work appropriate. If you wanted to umph it up, obviously I would recommend a wing. If you didn't talk through this, one, if you had all of your products ready to go and not in a different room where you had to keep running back and forth like I did, if you weren't filming this, it would take you a lot less time. You can get down to a routine of 10 minutes maximum. This is what I'm thinking of work appropriate makeup, no brand, glasses, makeup. Hit every single one of those marks. So thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this, please hit the like button. Please hit subscribe. I would love to have you. Leave any suggestions, requests down below, and thank you for hanging out with me on this very snowy day. Oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God, almost dropped that, almost. It was so close, you guys. You have no idea how close I was to just dropping everything again.